rush to get through. We've got 2.5 minutes to get it.
Ed's rider 3.
Up there, you going now?
Yeah. So right now we're rigging the bike up for sound.
Right now, I'm just taping the cameras in just for some extra security. So I've got some elastic bands around them, and just an extra little bit of tape. Not really needed, but it's just a bit of extra security.
Sounds like a long dress.
Whoever's got the goggles on has got stuff they can see. Mm. You know, if you look over the right shoulder, they're going to see the bikes coming by.
It's small on there.
We're going to review all the footage and see what we've got, but we think it's pretty good. Certainly Paul seems to be pretty happy about it. And then the plan is to go back to Flyer HQ and work with the actors on the car, on the crash car. So we'll probably rehearse the lines a little bit more and drive the route, and then it's start recording.
We are mounting in the mount for the camera, for the 360 camera, which is two GoPros stuck together, and we're tying it to the headrest so it sort of sits where the head of our character will rest.
The VR kind of does a bump when you go over it. Yeah, not so much, but if it's constant and you're wearing your headset, then you start to feel sick very quickly.
Right, yeah, okay.
Which is kind of one of the biggest issues in VR is motion sickness.
We are planning, we're destroying this car, completely obliterating it so it looks like they just had a nasty accident with the tractor over there. And we're briefing all of the staff, so we're talking to the first responder now. This is Sarah, and Sarah will be the first one on the scene. She's going to assess everyone who's injured at the scene. They're about to smash that window, so who's got an axe?
Thank you.
Don't worry about that.
This is covered, yeah. Yeah, as long as this is covered, it's fine. It's not going to go down here.
Yeah, so, do you want her further out?
Yeah, I think probably further out. It's also a bit of kind of mid-air, they sort of need to be...
That's unfair.
I've got fake blood dripping up my nose.
I'm a bit terrified. My leg looks horrible. There's a lot of elements going on. We're trying to coordinate with all the fire service and the ambulance and the helicopter now to get everyone converging at this point at the right time.
And then straight out and onto there.
Yeah. Everybody happy about that? Yeah.
So if she comes over, I'll get to see spine.
She can do, yeah. I'd say she's in a traumatic arrest, so, but yeah, we can control it straight out onto there. Brilliant.
Happy go. Right, we're getting back there.
So what we're going to do, she's going to have a tube and a mag, which we would have. So basically, she'll be lying on there.
Okay.
We're going to disconnect all of that, put a blanket overhead, and wheel her up into bed. Is that the plan?
That's perfect.
Is that okay like that? And then we're going to secure it.
Normally, you want to breathe in, so that wouldn't be a problem.
But we'll be doing that for you.
And all we're going to do is just when we finish it, we're just going to pull that off and put a blanket over your head. Okay?
And then I'm dead.
And then you're dead.
That's it.
Job done.
So I'm here with Paul Spate from Leicestershire Fire and Rescue Service on the set of the UK's very first crash car virtual reality film. The brainchild of Paul Spate. What made you want to take this step?
Well, since I've been kind of delivering road safety presentations, I've always liked to think outside the box, basically. We started with a vehicle crash car simulator, and I thought that now needs moving on into a new kind of next generation, and that's virtual reality filming. And I contacted James, the first car, and we've got heads together, and we've come up with this film set. So it looks like a proper real road traffic collision. We've actually had someone turn around on the road and go back the other way and phone up saying they couldn't attend the meeting. It's been a serious accident. So, you know, so we know we've got the real reality there. It looks absolutely spot on.
And that's the kind of immersive experience that we're looking for. We've actually got a 360-degree camera mounted point of view of the front seat passenger with a mannequin and prosthetic legs underneath, which at this post-crash stage have mimicked proper compound injuries. And we're just washing up now on the final set.
Yeah. Ready for the last scene?
Just before 6 o'clock.
Yeah, it's been a long day, but I think the outcome and when it's finished and all ready to view, I think we're going to have something which is going to be extraordinary.
So I'm Sam, Johnny. So we're from Uni in Pro 360. And we are kind of the camera team helping out on production today and shooting on VR with this little rig here. It's been an absolutely fantastic day. It's really interesting kind of shooting it all and seeing it all come together, and most importantly seeing all the kind of emergency services really kind of working together and kind of seeing how it all comes together and works. And when it's all kind of finally stitched together and made into the VR film, it's going to be absolutely outstanding. And that's one of the most important things about virtual reality, is how it can affect people's lives and stuff like that. And being kind of in a first person in a car crash in a virtual reality headset, the empathy kind of side of it is just going to be absolutely astounding.
It would be perfect. Okay, I'll say bogeys. 3, 2, 1.
Marvelous.
Lovely. Okay.